Hey, hey, welcome back to another episode, and this time we're back at the record stores. I know the Mishima Skywalk was awesome, and I'm hoping you loved the fadeaways and psychotic turnbuckle videos, but they weren't record stores, and I did promise you record stores. I'm going to two today. Now, on this street, I'll probably go to more, and so you'll probably see tons more in this video today, because I don't actually have any plans until like 7:30 tonight, which is when I'm going to a welcome party. But we have a punk and hardcore record store on this street. And I've forgotten the name of this street. I really have. But Shinjuku Station is parallel to it, right there. Seibu Shinjuku Station. So we're going to go to a store called Nat Records, which I've known about for years. And I'm pretty sure I've even been here before, the last time I was here in 2011. And here's a sign for it. Now they're open at 11, and I think it's 11 now. So we're going to go up and have a look. I think if this is a place I'm thinking of, the last time I was here, I bought the Victims reissue on 1977 Records. I'm pretty sure it was from here. And the guys were awesome, and they had an amazing selection of great garage punk and rock and roll records. So let's go up and check it out. There's a sign, very simple. Pretty sure it's down here. Awesome. Dan, here's one I've never seen. Oh, there it is. This is for you, Dan. This is always for you. Every time there's a Kiss record. A white label, deluxe cover, 1980 Wembley, London. So, live in London. Nothing there. The track listing, if you can see it, is through there. But, yeah, a Kiss bootleg. Nice. This store, Nat Records, is really cool. Lots of really interesting things in here, including a Francois Hardy section, which is awesome. I just love all this sort of stuff, this French pop. Sylvie Barton, she was big here, I guess. 60s girl pop. I'm always looking in the W section to see if I can find Wild Hearts records, because I'm still needing a copy of Earth vs. the Wild Hearts. Here's the heavy metal section. That's cool. I've never seen that cover before. And it's still got the insert, a 5x color pinup, and a sticker. So there you go. Bang Your Head. That's awesome. So there's a sticker in the front. I've never seen this before. Love it. So good. Hey, there's a Cows single here. Oh, there's Angel Lynn's single. Really? Wow. I did not know that came out. I'm going to grab this. Cows Plowed on AMRAP. Rocket Ship by John Spencer. Urges. Clitoris, yeah. Australian band. There we go. What else we got here? T-shirts. T-shirts are always good. I need something new to wear. Thrasher. Oh, the black and white. Awesome. That's extra small though. Medium, small. None of these are gonna fit me. Oh my god. Not having much luck. And we're listening to the Ramones in the background, so that's always a good thing. And so, okay. But this could be a while. So what I'll do is, what's this one? Bad Religion doing covers? Wow, I've never seen this before. Really? I've never seen that before. That's awesome. I'll come back when I've found some really juicy stuff. Here's another rarity. No Control of the Country Club. Got Bad Religion instead, Carrie Nation Visual Discrimination. I remember seeing this at Spiral Objective all the time. Wow, that's so cool. There you go. Lookouts. Nice. Iggy, Johanna, Angry Samoans, Real Kids, the Imposters, Paul Collins. Okay, this is, I've got a story about this. I bought this and I found it. I can't remember where I found it. It was cheap though. This one's not too bad. It's like $20. And me and my friend Arthur listened to the Antipasti songs on repeat while we were in Melbourne one day. And we just couldn't stop laughing at them. Not because it was bad or anything, but just because of how, like, you know, get fucked it is. And it's just so funny. But I don't know where that record went. So I feel like I should probably grab it again for memory's sake. Clash, but I mean, there is a lot of good stuff in here. There's Eddie and the Hot Rods and stuff like that. So there's a lot of good stuff tucked away here. Nat Records. Okay, so what do we got here? The Netherlands. This has got to be interesting for sure. Yeah, there we go. That's a cool one. Good old Happy Happy Knots. No hard-ons though. I just expect everywhere I go to see hard-ons records, but then the fact that I don't means that people are holding on to them, which is good because you should. Because why would you want to sell that stuff? Use 90s punk. Okay. This band is awesome. Got Tammy out as well. So this is what I love. Everything here is rated. Like, everything. It's always rated. And I love the fact that they're so particular about that because, you know, a lot of shops just aren't. But here in Japan, it seems like everybody is. And I think that's really cool. Peaches, there you go. Give a patrol, the crystals. Awesome band. Mm-hmm. There's a Green Day bootleg. There you go. Live in Italy. Nice. These magazines. This is good stuff. Just check out like what's in them. Like this, the Bobby Teens. And then this one, the Muffs. Blondie. Agnostic Front. This magazine rules. Chromax. The Dickies. That's what they've got. I did find this here, and so I'm going to grab it. It's 100 yen. A copy of No Answers fanzine, which, there you go. Legendary Kent McLeod magazine and Evolution Records and stuff like that. Awesome. That looks cool. That was a look at Nat Records. They have some good stuff. Some things there I'll probably come back and grab on my last day here, if I've still got money. Just things that like I don't, they're not Japanese, but like they're just things that like I don't see around often. So if I've still got money, it's like I'll just go grab them. Like why not? Like I'm here. It'll save me getting them with postage later on. But they have some really good stuff there. So I highly recommend if you're in Shinjuku area, you check out that store if you like power pop, garage punk, and stuff like that. So I've got like 3 records or something like that and a zine. Just something to read because I like reading. And, you know, every time I'm on the train, I kind of Wi-Fi. So I'm just sitting there, you know, twiddling my thumbs. You can't really see out the window. There's not much going on in the subway. So I'm going to try this place here, which is called Strange Love Records. So we're going to check them out. But they're open at 1, and it's not 1 now. So I'll come back and do that later. So now we're going to head to Koenji, which is where he recommended to go to find metal records at a shop called Boy. So I'm going to go check them out. And he said they have a lot of metal. So we're going to go to Boy and check that out. And then we're also going to go to Bass Records. But he said, he just told me that Bass doesn't have much used, if anything. So that's going to be interesting if it's all new stuff. But we'll go and see what punk stuff they've got because they are like very well known. And so, let's see where that takes us. Let's go catch a train. Well, I'm in Tokyo today, in Shinjuku. And I'm standing outside the Park Hyatt Tokyo. If you know anything about this building, you know that it is the filming location of one of my all-time favorite movies. There's my Lost in Translation shirt. So there we go. We can really get into the spirit of things here as we check out the Park Hyatt Tokyo. I want to go inside and see if I can go to the bar and have a look where they filmed the scenes with Scarlett and Bill Murray. I cannot believe I'm here, and it's one of my favorite movies of all time. And now I'm actually standing at the filming location of that movie. Total nerdery here, okay? If you've never seen the movie Lost in Translation, I suggest watching it. It was made by Sofia Coppola, and I believe she did not get permits to film in this city. She just went ahead and did it. And so I love that style of guerrilla filmmaking, if that's true. But like I said, we're here. And let's go in and have a look at the bar. The famous bar. Let's do it. Can't believe I'm here. You would recognize this from the movie, right? This whole area. And this thing. Wow.
So yeah, we are here with my new friends from France.
I'm in Nakano, Broadway.
man, this place is insane. If you're a toy collector, do not come here because you will be broke. But I'm here because it's just cool to look at. So we're going to check out stuff. We've got Mandaraki on the left and right, which, if you know, it's a comic store that is just insane. Like, just comics and stuff and anime. It's really, really cool. But look at all these toys. Gacha gachas. But like, I came in here many years ago and found a place called Rico Mint, which was like a used CD store. It's not here. That's where it was, right behind me. That was Rico Fan, the CD store, used CD store, and it's gone now. So, no more. I do remember this store here. It had one of the Ramones Pinhead dolls, like in the window last time I was here. Obviously, it's gone now because that was like 12 years ago or something. But it's still cool to see what is still here. How freaky would it be if it was still here? Wow. Look at that. That's what I'm talking about. Holy shit. Wow. BBA. Wow. And then on this side as well. Look, they've even got the Rancor. Remember how rare that thing was when you were a kid? Incredible. Places like Star Wars City. Here as well. Look at all this stuff. This is incredible. So basically this whole area is a collector's market. And if you're really into collecting stuff, this is bad news for you, mate. Bad news, because you're gonna spend a lot of money here. I didn't buy a thing though, because I'm here for records, not toys. But I wanted to show it to you because I still think it's pretty cool and you can find some good stuff in there. I remember the very first time I ever came here in 2006, I remember seeing those Misfits figures, like the really good detailed ones. They were here and you could check them out. But anyway, let's go look at some record stores. My friend Hugo used to live here in this area, so I got to know this area quite well. And there is a Disc Union here that I'm going to go to, because this Disc Union I found so much cool shit at, and it was really, really cheap. And so I'm looking forward to going back there and checking out and making sure it's still just as awesome as I remember it, because there was tons of stuff there. So this is in Nakano, so it's one stop away on the Chuo line. So if you're looking to find some more, you know, records out this way or whatever, come on out to Nakano. But like I said, we're going into Disc Union now, and so we'll check it out and hopefully we'll find some goodies. Alrighty, so we're here in the metal section, and automatically we see this, an original. There you go, 22,850 yen, so over 200 bucks. But still, it's here if you want a pestilence. Zeppelin, Deep Purple. Okay. See, rat is everywhere here, man. It's awesome. We all could use a lot of rat in our life. Look at this. Dan, have you seen this one before? Wow, Strutter 78 and Shock Me. There you go. It's like 90 bucks. Rock. Let's see. Okay. Metal. Okay, so this is new stuff. We're only looking for used. But progressive rock, we don't want that. Okay. Punk and hardcore. Let's see what we can see. Doom. How good is Doom? Like, seriously. Liver than you'll ever be. I don't know this Dead Boys record. It's less than $10. It's a double LP too. When was this recorded? Well, there's the lineup of it. Oh, it's this one. Okay. Nice. I would probably buy that Dead Boys if I was into live records, but I'm not a huge live record fan. I don't listen to them enough to warrant the money, even though it's less than $10. Gives them high standard. There we go. But, you know, maybe I'll change my mind as I leave. You never know. Stranger things have happened. Okay, Japanese heavy metal. Now, let's see. Will we get lucky? No, we'll never get lucky. But here we go, some others. Smashed Gladys. This album is really good and it's like $6. Like, I have this record already, but if you don't, you need to get this record. The first song in it is called Lick It Into Shape. Brilliant. Tiger Pantang. Alrighty. Okay, we got some Japanese punk and hardcore here. So we'll see what we got. See what we can find. Okay. Hotshot, I remember them. Husking B. This is that band that the guy recommended to me. He said like we're like Japanese NoFX. I'll get that. Because I bought the single and I really liked the songs on the single. There you go. Gauze. Crazy stuff, it's awesome. Switch Trout. Wow. The Star Club. They're like a big deal here. Slight Slappers. The Stalin. The guy recommended me that as well when I was at that store. He paid it for me and it was good. It was really good. Okay, Rockabilly. Let's see if we can find Biscuits. Kids, awesome. What else we got? Lots of Dead Boys in all the stores I go to. I'm always seeing Dead Boys records. There you go, Nomads, nice. Hey, this is a good comp. The Vile Tones. There you go, what's this? Is this a studio record? That's cheap. Okay, that's an awesome record. Come and get it, you need to. To find this punk stuff, you've got to come up here and have a look. So I have to put the phone down so I can go through it all. But if I find anything good, I'll be sure to put it on the video. And there's a heavy metal section too. Awesome, check this one out, Dan. Shout It Out Loud, it's like $15. Look at that cover, that's so good. Nothing to lose on the flip. There you go, that's so cool. Love it. Well, that was a trek and it was awesome. I found a bunch of Japanese stuff and it was super cheap. There's a sale on, How cool is that? And I walked in and basically all this stuff that I bought, the price just kept coming down. So that is awesome. I'm not gonna tell you what I bought, but yeah, you'll just have to wait and enjoy when I do that unveiling video. But yeah, some cool Japanese stuff in there. So that's really, really awesome, because that's why I came here, to find Japanese records. And I found like seven Japanese records, six or seven just then. So yeah, I'm pretty happy. Awesome. Let's move on to Koenji, where we will go to record shop base and that metal store called Boys. Let's check it out. So I'm now in Koenji. I'm now at record shop base. Wasn't easy to find, but some dude helped me, because he was walking in the same direction apparently. But we are here, and you can tell because there are posters here. I've been here before in 2011 when we had our punk record buying thing. So look at these gigs. So this is awesome. So let's go in. Oh, look at that. How adorable. I love you, Japan. We are at Record Boy. There's an axe on the door. So awesome. This is very manual already. All right. Okay, so I just went into Boy Records, and I didn't film anything in there because the music was just insane. And like, it was full on blast beat, grindcore and stuff, and it was really loud, and so it would just be noise on the video probably. On top of that, so I couldn't talk about anything. On top of that, I had to wear a mask, which is fine. I don't have any issue with that. I wear a mask when they ask. That's fine. I found a record that I've been looking for 20 years, and it was there, and it was 500 yen. That's what I'm talking about, my friends. And I will show you later on. All right, let's go. I don't know about you guys, but I'm hungry and I feel like a crepe. Do you feel like a crepe? I feel like a crepe. Let's go to Harajuku and get a Harajuku crepe. Sounds good to me. We're in Harajuku and we are going to Erostika and to get a crepe. And why not? Place is busy as, it's kind of crazy, filled with tourists and stuff, but we're here for a crepe because the crepes are awesome. And we're also going to Rock and Jelly Bean store, which is here, Erostika, and check out all his incredible artwork. So yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Look at that. Oh yeah, we are going to have one of those. So here it is, a double choc and cream Harajuku crepe. These things are a big deal here. They're very famous, and I highly recommend if you come to Harajuku, you have one, and you will anyway, because they're awesome. And yeah, this costs 600 yen, so about $7 or $8. It'll do. I'm hungry, I need something cold. And so yeah, I'm gonna eat this. I'm not gonna film me eating it because that would be disgusting. Erostika, my friends, the home of Rock and Jelly Bean. We are going there next, as soon as I scoff this down. Okay, I'm in this store in Harajuku that has Rolling Stone stuff, and check it out, signed. Nice. That's pretty awesome. But yeah. Okay, the main drag of Harajuku is behind me. That's the main street where everybody gets excited over, and it's really crowded and stuff. So apart from crepes, there's not really much else that I would do in there. I mean, there's a lot of clothing and stuff, but it's not really my thing. So if you cross the road though, and you walk down this road, you will get to Erosika. This road is way less crowded, so much easier to get through. And there's lots of like shoe shops and sports shops, and there's a skate shop on the corner. But yeah, I don't know if there's any record store. There'd have to be a record store here in Harajuku. I don't know where it is though. But Erosika is down here, and it stands out, and it's pretty awesome. Like I said, you're a fan of rock and roll and artwork and stuff, then you are no doubt familiar with the artwork of Rock and Jellybean. And he has his own store, which is down here. And here it is, Erosika. Rock and Jellybean. So we're going to go up the stairs and check it out. I haven't been here since 2019, and I bought his book the last time I was here. But here we are. Alrighty, are you ready? Let's do it. Thank you so much once again for tuning in to another episode of the Long Gone Is a Rock Show's guide to rock and rolling in Japan. I hope you've enjoyed this. What did we take in today? Nakano, Koenji, Harajuku, and we had crepes. How good are crepes? Seriously. Look after yourselves, take care of each other, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.